using power series to solve a homogeneous differential equation, and you are given x equals 0 is a regular singular point. So our final solution is given in this form, y equals power series from 0 to infinity, cn x to the n plus r. Take the first derivative gives me power series from 0 to infinity, cn n plus r, x to the n plus r minus 1. Yeah, so you bring down the exponent and then subtract the exponent by 1. Take the second derivative, give me power series from 0 to infinity, cn n plus r, x to the n plus r minus 2. It's also times n plus r minus 1, okay? So again, you bring down the exponent and then subtract the exponent by 1. So I guess this. And then you're going to plug these into the differential equation. So I'm going to have x times y to the prime, which is power series from 0 to infinity, cn n plus r minus 1, x to the n plus r minus 1. So you have x times x to the n plus r minus 2. So add the exponent together, which gives me n plus r minus 1, plus 2y prime, which is the power series from 0 to infinity, 2 cn n plus r, x to the n plus r minus 1, minus x times y, which is the power series from 0 to infinity, cn x to the n plus r plus 1 is equal to 0. Now we are going to take a look at the index of the power. So when n equals 0, letting 0 have x to the r minus 1. N equals 0, letting 0 have x to the r minus 1. Letting 0 have x to the r plus 1. So this is the highest exponent. And we are going to write out terms for each power series. Okay, letting 0 and have c naught r times r minus 1. X to the r minus 1, plugging 1, I have c1 r plus 1 times r, x to the r, okay, plus power series from 2 to infinity, cn n plus r minus 1, x to the n plus r minus 1, okay. But let me draw a line just with this steps. And now for the second one, I'm going to do the same thing, so run out terms. Letting 0, I have 2 c naught r x to the r minus 1. Okay? Plus, letting 1, I have 2 c1 r plus 1 x to the r plus power series from 0 from 2 to infinity, 2 c n plus r, n plus r minus 1 x to the n plus r minus 1, okay? And for the last one, we're going to rewrite it. But if you notice, we have n equal 2, n equal 2, and n equal 0. So I'm going to reinvest this at this point, because I'm going to save my time for the next step. So reinvest this to 2, so I have power series from 2 to infinity. So add 2, so I have a subtraction for every single n inside. So I have c n minus 2, x to the n plus r minus 1. And they are equal to 0. Right? Now we are going to combine like terms. So look at this. So we have c naught r times r minus 1 and then 2 c naught r. They are all multiplied by x to the r minus 1. Okay? So c naught r in common factor of tau. And what I have left in front of c is r minus 1 plus 2, which is r plus 1, times x to the r minus 1. Okay, for this one, c1 r plus 1, c1 r plus 1 in common, factor it out, c1 r plus 1, and then what I have left in front of c is r plus 2, r multiplied by x to the r, plus power series from 2 to infinity, okay, now factor x to the n plus r minus 1. And put it at the end, okay? So in parentheses, I have cn n plus r, cn n plus r in common, okay? Factor it out. Oh, sorry, guys. I made a mistake right here, so just realize it. So for this one, you plug in 0, which you have this one, and plug in 1, and you have this one. And then when you start to just rewrite this, but I have it in plus r minus 1, so it's not supposed to be here. So we'll have this term, bad. Okay, so just this. Alright, so these incomers are factored out, and then I have n plus r minus 1 plus 2, which is n plus r plus 1, then minus cn minus 2, okay? So this is what I have, right? Now we are going to equate coefficient. So I have c naught r times r plus 1 is equal to 0, c1 r plus 1 r plus 2 is equal to 0, and everything inside the bracket is equal to 0, cn n plus r. N plus r minus 1 minus cn minus 2 is equal to 0. So this is our system of equations. Okay? Now, we are going to solve for this. So for the first one, we're going to solve for r. Then I have r equals 0, r negative 1. So this is my r values. You can solve, you can use either one of these three equations to solve for r, but I like to solve for the first one because I just keep it in order, okay? And I didn't solve for c naught because if you solve for c naught, it's going to be 0, and for the final solution, you're going to have y equals c naught times something. Then since c naught is 0, so y is just 0, then it's helpless. So do not solve for c naught, okay? Now for the first case, we're going to take a look at when r equals 0. Okay? So r equals 0, plugging 0 into this one. These two equations, so I have C1 equals 0, which means that C1 is equal to 0. Excuse me. Plugging 0 into this one, I just noticed another mistake that I made. So over here I have n plus r plus 1, but I throw negative sign here, so it's a positive sign. So plugging 0 into this one, I have Cn times n plus n plus 1 minus Cn minus 2 is equal to 0. Then solve for the C, which is Cn. So I have Cn equals negative Cn minus 2 over n times n plus 1. Okay? And n is starting from 2 to infinity. So when n equals 2, I have C2. Plugging 2, I have C2 equals C0 over 2, 3, 6. When n equals 3, I have C3 is equal to, plugging 3, I have C1. Over, so since C1 is 0, so I don't care about what's on the bottom, is, because we are going to have 0 eventually. When n equals 4, plugging 4, I have C4 equals C2 over 4, 5, 20. And what is C2? C2 is C0 over 6, so I have C0 over 120. Okay? And when n equals 5, plugging 5, you're gonna have C5 in terms of C3, and C3 is 0, so C5 is 0. Okay, so I'm gonna write my solution here. So y1 is equal to x to the r, c0 plus c1x plus c2x squared plus dot dot dot. So what is x to the r? And what is r? R is 0, so x is 0. Oops. c0, we don't know, just rewriting. What is c1? c1 is 0. What is c2? c2 is c0 over 6. What is c3? 0. c4? c4 is c0 over 120. Okay. Factor out c0, then we have 1 plus 1, 6x squared. Plus 1 over 120x to the 4th plus dot dot dot. Okay, now we are going to do the same thing for r equals negative 1. Okay, so I'm going to do it over here so that you can compare. I'm trying to squeeze everything into one page. Okay, alright, so since everything is the same, it's similar to this one, so I'm just work through it and then I don't go over step by step, okay, like I did for r equals 0, right? Okay, now I have y1 is equal to this and y2 is equal to this. So our final solution is equal to y1 plus y2. And keep in mind that this c0 and this c0 are not the same. So for the first one, I'm going to rewrite it. And for the second one, do not replace this c0 at c1. Okay? So that's it. That's your final solution. Here is a bonus. So your final solution is this one, y1 plus y2. But you can rewrite it. You can rewrite it as a core power series. So let me show you. So for y1, you have c0. So this is 1 plus. So 1 over 6, I'm going to rewrite it as 3 factorial x squared plus one protein will be ready times 5 factorial x to the 4 squared by that, okay? And this becomes C naught times power series from 0 to infinity 1 over 2n plus 1 factorial x to the 2n. Okay, so let's double check. So when n equals 0, you have 1 over 1 factorial, which is 1. When n equals 1, so you have 2 times 1 plus 1, 3 factorial x to the second, right? Now for y2. So like I said earlier, you're going to call it as c1. Then you have 1 plus 1 over 2 factorial, okay? X squared plus 1 over 4 factorial x to the fourth plus that, that. So we notice that these are just, this the second one is just a opposite of this one. No, not really opposite, but it's this one is odd and this one is even. So you have C1 x to negative 1 power series from 0 to infinity 1 over 2n factorial x to the 2n. Okay? Now our final solution is equal to y1 plus y2, which is this plus this. Okay? So C0 times power series from 0 to infinity 1 over 2n plus 1 factorial x to the 2n plus C1 x to the negative 1 power series from 0 to infinity 1 over 2n factorial times x to the 2n. Alright? That's it. That's your final solution.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.